So we will continue this integral control volume analysis, and in this session we will be discussing the linear momentum balance coupled with Reynolds transport theorem. So Reynolds transport theorem plus linear or conservation of linear momentum. So that is Newton's law. So here you see that Fs plus Fb, it's equal to dp dt system, where p the total linear momentum, it's equal to volume of the system into v rho dv. So n to be used in Reynolds transport theorem is p and eta is v. So now Reynolds transport theorem states that dn dt system is equal to del del t integral control volume eta rho dv plus eta rho v dot d. So if I write this n to be replaced by dp or p, so it becomes fs plus fb, and that's equal to del del t cv v rho dv plus integral cs v rho v dot d. So this is the form, but this is not a working form. In order to get the respective working form, we have to resolve it into three scalar equations. Along x-axis, let's focus on Cartesian coordinate primarily, along x-axis, along y-axis, and along z-axis. So along x-axis, if we focus, so it will be fsx plus fbx. So this is what? The surface force component along x direction and the body force component along x direction is equal to del del t integral cv. Now let's think that v, its component of u small v and small w. So this v will be replaced by u rho dv, plus here this v will be replaced by u. However, the v present in dot product will remain as it is, because we check that whenever we are resolving it, any equation into scalar component, we should be taking, or we should take this scalar component of eta, and we should not disturb any other quantity. Like v is here present in the original expression of Reynolds transport theorem, so it should be appearing same in this scalar component equation. So for y coordinate, fsy plus fby del del t integral cv u rho dv, sorry, v rho dv plus integral cs v rho v dot d. And for z component, fsz plus fbz del del t integral cv w rho dv plus cs w rho v dot d. So these three are the fundamental working equation, right? So with these three equations, now we will try to solve some of the problems.
think. What is the statement? Water from a stationary nozzle strikes a flat plate as shown. What is that?
Here we have a plate mounted on a support like this, and water from a stationary nozzle is striking this plate and it is diverging radially outward.
Right. Then water leaves the nozzle.
Here let's say we have the nozzle.
Water leaves the nozzle at a velocity of 15 meter per second.
So here the velocity is 15 meter per second.
The nozzle area is 0.01 meter square.
This area, which is same as that of the area of this jet, is 0.01 meter square.
Assuming the water is directed normal to the plate and flows along the plate, determine the horizontal force you need to resist, or you need to horizontal force you need to resist to hold the plate in place.
So basically, if I think of a control volume, what amount of force this support is exerting on the plate in order to hold the plate in position is basically the point we have to solve.
Right.
So for that, we'll consider a control volume like this. So this is my control volume.
But there is a detail to be understood. Actually, the control volume is cylindrical, because whenever the water jet strikes the plate and moves away, it actually moving along the plate in a radial direction, right? And we have to choose the control volume in such a way so that everywhere it is perpendicular to the flow port. So it must be cylindrical.
So in 3D, it will look like, see, so this is my control volume. Here we have the plate. And this is the support. Whereas the water jet is striking the plate and moving in all possible directions. It's moving out radially. Like this. So, here the support is exerting a force. So first, in order to solve this problem, we have to fix our coordinate system. So this is x, this is y. And let's say the force being exerted on the control volume is Rx, which actually keeping the control volume in, or this entire plate in position. Right? So what we are going to apply? We are going to apply the x directional component equation. But before that, we have to go specify the assumptions. Number one, steady flow. Number two, incompressible flow, because it is what? So with that, let's start, and with time we will add more assumptions to be used to solve the problem. So Fsx plus Fbx del del t integral cb u rho dv plus integral cs u rho v dot d. So third, obviously the body force along x direction is zero. There is no gravity and there is no other forces specified. So this is my assumption 3. this term is 0 by assumption of steady state. So fsx is equal to integral rho or u rho v dot d. Say this is over control surface, and actually you see it's entering through the flow port 1 and leaving through the flow port 2. 2 is actually this also, right? It's a radial strip. So this we can further write fsx as integral over 1, area 1 basically, u rho v dot dn plus integral over 2 u rho v dot d. Now what are the surface forces acting on this specific control volume? You see, it's a cylinder and it's closed. So on this side we have atmospheric pressure acting, which will cancel out with the atmospheric pressure acting in the reverse direction, and pressure will always act inward. So if this surface area, let's say it is A prime, the entire surface area including this jet area as well. So we can write that P atmosphere or PSX is equal to P atmosphere into A prime minus P atmosphere into A prime plus there is another surface force which is this Rx. And that's equal to u rho v dot d, right? So rho, it is incompressible, it's out. Now u is nothing but v bar because it is horizontally striking. V is also v bar. And here you see, we have discussed it in mass conservation. The direction of area is this, direction of velocity is this. So included angle is 180 degree. So the sign of the dot product will be minus. So u is v, then rho, then v, then a with a minus sign,
right?
Now for the
port 2, now in the port 2 we have a radial component. There is no component along x direction, so essentially for port 2 u is equal to 0, so the integral vanishes.
So this is equal to 0. So this term and this term cancels out, giving me the answer that Rx is equal to minus rho v square a. So it is, the answer will be 10 to the power 3 into v, v is 15 square into this 0.01 meter square or 0.01 meter square. Overall, the answer will be Newton.
Right. So you see that initially we have chosen the force Rx in the positive x direction, and from our intention, or sorry, this from our intuitive guess we know, and from our physical feel of about this system we know that if this is the disk and here we have the jet, we have to push the, or we have to give the force in the opposite x, or the negative of this x direction, and actually we have got that answer that Rx is equal to minus, so which is exactly consistent with our physical feel about the system, and that's why we can ensure that this is the correct answer, right? So next, another problem. Here instead of this plate, we'll be having a orifice. Having an orifice. So what is the diagram? Let's discuss it. This is the orifice plate. A jet is striking
moving out radially, but a part of a jet continues in the same direction.
What is given? A vertical plate has a sharp edged orifice at its center. A water jet of speed V.
This water jet has got a speed V.
Strikes the plate concentrically.
So here what is given? This is D. This is small d. This is also V. It's given in the problem statement. Right?
This is also V. Obtain an expression for the external force needed to hold the orifice in position. If the jet leaving the orifice also has speed V.
So that's the problem statement. So you see, first we have to draw the control volume. Again it will be cylindrical. The cylindrical once again. So this is port 1, this is port 2, and let's say the radial port is port 3.
Right?
So this is the radial port moving out.
So we'll be again assuming first
it's a steady state flow, second incompressible flow, FBX equal to 0. So the equation up to this will remain same, and additionally we have to add that 3 u rho v dot dA.
Right? But we have to consider
this force, external force necessary. Also, we are choosing the coordinate in the same direction.
Now, for the port 1, it will be the same because u is equal to v. Right?
The direction of area and direction of velocity, they are opposite to each other.
So the first term will be minus of rho into V square into area, which is pi by 4 capital V square. For the port 2,
now see, this is the direction of area, this is the direction of velocity.
Remember that direction of area will be always normal outward with respect to the control volume. And velocity, it's also the,
here it's same because it is the outward flow.
Right?
So the dot product giving cos 0, so the sign is positive. So rho v square pi by 4 small d square. Now at the port 3, which is the this circumferential port, right? So there is no u, so essentially just like the previous, the value is 0. So you get, and here FSX will be what? Again it's p atmosphere into a prime minus p atmosphere into a prime plus rx. So Rx we get as minus of rho V square pi by 4 capital D square minus small d square. Now capital D is greater than small d, right? And this Rx we are getting to be negative.
Why capital D will be greater than small d?
Because here the inflow rate, the mass flow rate will be rho into V into pi by 4 d square. Here the mass flow rate should be rho into V into pi by 4 small d square. Now the difference of this, this minus this, must be the mass flow rate in this. So definitely small d is smaller than capital D. And we are getting Rx to be negative.
Right? So next problem. Now I think that we must erase this. We have got an understanding of this basic equation. So we'll go on repeatedly using it. Water flows, water is flowing steadily the 180 degree elbow shown. So it is this.
This is 2 as given, and here this is 0.1.
At the inlet to the elbow, the gauge pressure is 103 kilopascal.
So here, the gauge pressure, which is above and over atmospheric pressure, as you all know, 103 kilopascal. The water discharges to atmospheric pressure, so at PGE2, the gauge pressure is 0.
It's releasing to atmospheric pressure. Assume properties are uniform over the inlet and outlet areas.
A1 is equal to 2500 millimeter square and A2 is equal to 650 millimeter square.
And V1
here, V1 is this 3 meter per second.
Find the horizontal component of the force required to hold the elbow in position. So we have to find out,
say if this is XY coordinate, we have to find out if this is the Rx we are using. So what is the value of the Rx?
So you see that here also, initially a 3D visualization is necessary.
Like, if this is the elbow,
so what will be the control surface?
In this diagram, it may be like this. Here, it will look like this.
Right? Okay. The diagram, I don't think it's quite clear.
So let's redraw it.
Now I think we can describe it better. So this is the ramp, right?
And this is my x and y axis. Now this area is A1 as given. Now the area, this dotted area, let's say it is A. Here this area is A2. And this dotted area is say A prime. So the back side, the area will be A1 plus A2 plus A plus A prime. It's obvious.
You see, this rectangle's area will be A plus A1 which is this much of area, and this rectangle's area is A2 plus A prime, which is this much of area. So total backside area is A1 plus A2 plus A plus A prime. Now we'll be applying the here the assumptions. As obvious, steady, uniform, sorry, this incompressible. If bx equal to 0, so I am not writing the entire equation, it reduces to this. If sx is equal to integral over control surface, this u rho v dot d, because it is steady state, and f bx is equal to 0. So fsx over this area, what are the forces? See, it is P atmosphere into A plus P atmosphere plus gauge pressure, which is acting inwardly. All pressures will act inwardly, that you have to note, into A1 over this cross sectional area here. Because we have a gauge pressure, so the pressure is acting inwardly. Plus P atmosphere into A prime, and also P atmosphere into A2. All pressures will act inward to that control surface. Now minus P atmosphere into A1 plus A2 plus A prime plus Rx. So that's equal to now the this term which we have to evaluate for port 1 and for port 2. Now what is the term for port 1? Here, this is direction of velocity, this is direction of area, so the sign of the dot product will be negative, so we will have minus of rho v1 squared A1. Now you don't know what is v2, v2 is not given in the problem statement, but you see, upon applying conservation of mass, we get mod this v dot da is equal to 0 over the control surface, because for unsteady state the first term will cancel out. So we'll get for the port 1 it will be minus v1a1 plus v2a2. This is typically the pipe continuity equation under incompressible state. So we get v2 is equal to v1 by a1, v1 into a1 divided by a, right? So we know v2 if I have the value of v1 and a1 and a2. Now for here, the velocity direction is this, area direction is this. So it will be plus rho v2 square a2. Right? So finally, all this term will cancel out, leaving PG1 into A1 and Rx. So PG1 into A1 plus Rx is equal to minus of rho V1 square A1 plus rho V2 square A2. But this is a wrong answer. Why I wanted to point out, we have done a little mistake, and that I wanted to point out. So intentionally I have done it wrong. Why? Because you see, for the second term here, we have this problem. Term u, the x is in this direction. So u is equal to minus v2, not v2. Okay? So you must be careful about the sign. So it is minus v2. Definitely the dot product sign is positive. But because of this, u is equal to minus v2, as it is v2 is a magnitude and it's moving along the negative x direction. So we have minus v2 over here. So pg1 into a1 plus Rx is equal to minus of rho V1 square A1 minus of rho V2 square A2. Right? And the last problem, what we are going to solve using this momentum balance, A nozzle shown discharges a sheet of water through 180 degree arc.
What is a nozzle or how it looks like? See, it looks like this.
Nozzle looks like this.
And here from this is the hollow region, and here from the liquid actually tires this out. So at the base, see, this is the structure. So at the base, here we fix our coordinate system as Z, X, and this is Y. The diameter is given. This is floret Q. R is given as 0.3 meter. Diameter is given as 0.2 meter. Velocity everywhere is 15 meter per second, and the thickness of this jet, that is this thickness, is 0.03 meter.
Now the first question, what is the statement? Let's see. The nozzle shown discharges a sheet of water through a 180 degree arc. The water speed is 15 meter per second and jet thickness is 30 millimeter at a radial distance of 0.3 meter from the center line of the supply pipe. First, there are two parts. First, find the volume flow rate of water in the jet sheet and the Y component of the force required to hold the nozzle in place. So first we will apply
the assumption. Let's write the assumption first. First is steady state. And second, it is incompressible flow. So with that, if we start, see, so conservation of mass gives V dot dA over CS equal to 0.
Now, here it is an inflow. So the term should be minus of V into A, right? Minus of V into A, and V into A is Q. So for the port 1, the term is minus Q. Because here it will be V into A and it will be equal to Q. And over port 2, this is control volume here and the system here are exactly identical. We can think that this is basically the control volume. I should have told you previously. But it's pretty obvious that this is basically the control volume. The control volume and the system, they are identical, right? So this is control volume.
So at the, this is port 1, and let's say this is port 2, the entire arc, circular arc.
So at port 2, the velocity everywhere is uniform and it is perpendicular to the control surface because it is radial, right? So it is V into A once again. Now what is A? Pi into R into T. That area is this area.
And it will be a plus sign because it is outgoing flow. So V into pi into R into T. And that's equal to 0. So we can calculate Q as pi R T into V, which is 3.14. Then 0.3, then this T, which is 0.03, into V, which is 15 this meter cube per second.
That's pretty simple. Next, so Y component of the force. Now here you see, if I look it from the top view, this is the pipe, and here
this is the y coordinate. And we have the flow in radial direction. So, if I write the balance, Fsy, steady state the first term is 0, then integral v rho v dot dl. Right?
Now you see, over this control volume,
which looks like this in projection,
the atmospheric pressure on this side,
and atmospheric pressure will be acting radially inward,
they must cancel out, right? Because the atmospheric pressure which is acting on the circular arc, we have to take the components and that must cancel out, otherwise this object will start moving, because here this is a flat surface, this is a curved surface, so we have atmospheric pressure everywhere acting, and that is actually cancelling out each other, giving you no unbalanced force.
So what you can write directly, that we'll consider this force to be is equal to ry. So write that p atmosphere into a minus p atmosphere into a. That's for convenience and for understanding, but actually it will cancel out. And that's equal to v rho v dot d.
Now you see that v is changing its direction, right? So essentially the y component of velocity, that is small v, is also changing. Think that at this point this is v and this angle, let it be theta. So this value, y component value, will be v sin theta because this is theta, right? And in this here, it will look like this. So we will consider a strip between theta and theta plus d theta. So actually, it will be looking like this. This area we are focusing. So this is theta, this region is d theta. Right? This is theta, this region is d theta. And this area, what will be the area? This darkened area, it will be this r, the arc length will be r d theta into t. T is the thickness, because this is r d theta, this is r d theta multiplied by t. So dA is equal to r d theta t, and v is equal to v, whereas small v is equal to v sin theta. So we'll substitute, and the sign of the dot product will be positive because it is outward. So ry is equal to integral v sin theta into rho into v into this rt d theta. Right? And it is to be integrated from 0 to pi. 0 to pi. So we'll be getting what? Rho into v square into r into t into integral sin theta d theta, that is minus of cos theta 0 to pi. So this pi, it is cos of pi, so it is actually giving you 2 rho v square r t. That will be equal to r o. Right? So that's all about the force balance, rather the linear conservation of moment, conservation of linear momentum, and the Reynolds transport theorem. In the next session, we will be discussing this energy conservation, and from there straight away we will derive Bernoulli's equation incorporating pump and head losses.